गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ मिस दीप्ति फ्रॉम डिप्स करोलबाग. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 8 एजुकेशन एंड ब्रिटिश रूल. एंड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस हाउ द ब्रिटिश हैव इंट्रोड्यूस द एजुकेशन पॉलिसीज इन इंडिया, व्हाट वाज इट्स मेरिट्स एंड व्हाट वाज इट्स डिमेरिट्स. And in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the two case studies has been given in your chapter data. One is the Baroda and another one is the Aligarh. So let's start. Baroda. Baroda is an important city in of Gujarat. The city was modernized by Maharaja Shivaji Rao III. He wanted to give a good education, good and free education to all, and he worked for the upliftment of the poor. So it is a very important, nowadays Baroda is a very important city of Gujarat state, and it was modernized by the Maharaja Shivaji Rao III, who was the king of the Baroda state. So he want that everyone should be given a good and free education, as well as he has also worked for the upliftment of the poor. He had a good collection of books which was stored in the central library of Baroda. He set up a lot of libraries in towns and villages in the state. It said that in 1906 he started free and compulsory education in his state. Maharaja Shivaji Rao III led the foundation of Baroda College. The other institutes were Bhartiya Sangeet Vidyalaya, established in 1886, and Kal Bhavan Technological Institute, started in 1819. Shivaji Rao University was set up in the year 1949 by his grandson Pratap Singh Gaikwad, and the university is famous for its faculty and subject offered. So here is a small case study regarding the Baroda, a small and important city of Gujarat state. And the Maharajas of this state have all before independence. Before independence, it was a state. So the Maharaja of the state, Shivaji Rao, has given the free and compulsory education to his all people. So one thing I want to tell you, that the free and compulsory education to all was given to each and every person, to Indian also, after the independence. And our constitution maker have made this thing in, keep it this thing in the mind, that free education should be given, free and compulsory education should be given into everybody. So they have taken from this idea, come to them from this, from Maharaja Shivaji Rao's third step taken by him. So next is the Aligarh. Aligarh, as previously we have read, it is an important town located in the Uttar Pradesh, and it is famous for Aligarh Muslim University was set up in 1920. Muslim leaders Hidayatullah Khan and Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan brought Islam into conformity with the modern science. They educate Muslims and made them enter government services. Sir Sayyid made Muslim understand the importance of English for progress. So Aligarh University is very important in university, who played an important role in the upliftment of Muslims. And Sayyid Hidayatullah Khan and Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, these were the two important person who established this university. And the main motto of this establishing this university was to make Muslim people to get educated in English medium and get government services, so that they can develop themselves. So Muhammad Anglo-Oriental College was founded in Aligarh in 1875, which were later become the Aligarh Muslim University. And Sir Sayyid reforms movement was called the Aligarh movement. Sultana Jahan Begum was the first woman chancellor of Aligarh University, Muslim University. This university has been one of those universities institution contributing great towards the shaping Indian history in the realms of education. So Aligarh Muslim University has played an important role in education in India, and Sir Syed Ahmed Khan was an important person. He was a social reformer, and Sir title was given by the British government to Mr. Ahmed Khan because of his work in the field of education as well as in the field of social upliftment also. So these are the quick case studies of in the education done by the people to promote education in India. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay healthy, and goodbye.